Well, Tom and Jen, Lisa Byron is pleading not guilty, and for a minute there it was looking like she might actually walk free today and be able to post bail, as the judge decided she did not pose a flight risk, but then that same judge determined that she did pose a possible danger to the community and should be held here in jail until her trial date early next year.
Just before a scheduled court hearing on charges of possessing images of child sexual abuse, the FBI whisked suspect Lisa Byron away in a white car, taking her to U.S. District Court in Concord. There, she was arraigned on 7 federal felony charges. The indictment says in May, she transported a minor girl under the age of 18 to Ontario, Canada, with the intent that she would engage in sexual activity. U.S. Attorney John Kakavas says Byron used the website Craigslist to set up illegal encounters.
Craigslist was used by her as a mode of solicitation in order to solicit men, adults, some juveniles, to come and engage in sexual activities with a minor.
It appears at least some of those activities were recorded. Multiple counts allege Byron coerced a minor girl to engage in sexual conduct for the purpose of producing computer video files.
These are the most serious child pornography, child sexual exploitation charges in the federal criminal code. They carry substantial penalties because of the gravity of these offenses.
Manchester police arrested Byron, an attorney, in early October. In arguing against bail, prosecutors referenced alleged drug use, citing witness statements about the use of marijuana, cocaine, and ecstasy. Contending Byron could be a danger to the public if released, they said they have a text message Byron allegedly sent to a potential witness in this case, saying he needs to watch his back forever.
Lisa Byron's trial here in federal court is scheduled for January 8th. The U.S. attorney says he'll be working in cooperation with authorities in Hillsborough County to determine if the charges at the lower level there will still be going forward. Reporting live in Concord tonight, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.